So in our previous videos, we have seen about sedation dentistry, people who are in fear to get the dental treatment done, how they can get it done and while they are sleeping on the dental chair. And we have had many hundreds of patients who have been tremendously benefited by sedation dentistry. The reason that they have benefited is, one is the amount of work that is they have postponed because of their fear is too great. And it's not possible to do all the work in one visit, but with sedation dentistry we can do it. So in this video, let's see what are some of the commonest instructions that we will give the patient before the procedure and also after the procedure. And this is Dr. Arun from Pearls Dentistry, running our dental centers in Chennai Raja and Namalaipuram since the year 2001. If you have not subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to our channel. We've got more than 300 videos coming out in the next 1 year. So what are the commonest instructions that we usually give? Because when you give a sedation dentistry, we will expect the patients to be on a fasting. So when I say fasting, it's not an overnight fasting. It's 4 hours of solid fasting and 2 hours of liquid fasting. What it means is, when we schedule the procedure, 4 hours prior to the appointed time, we stop taking solids. So it can be like, say we schedule the procedure at 2 in the afternoon, we finish our breakfast or a brunch by 10 and then not take any solids after that. The reason is, when you're lying down, when we are sleeping, there can be some regurgitation of food that can happen because in our sleep, because we'll be in a deep sleep state. So we don't want the regurgitation of food to happen from our stomach to the mouth, which can disturb the sedation process. So that's the reason we'll ask you to come under solid fasting. Also, we'll also advise the patients to come under liquid fasting. When I say liquid fasting, it's not to take any water, even water, juices or anything, 2 hours prior to the procedure. So stop all both liquids as 2 hours prior to the procedure. Also, you will usually give a tablet, a simple tablet which will help to reduce the stomach acid and also to prevent any reflex of food content that is there in the stomach to come up to the mouth. So these are some of the medications, one tablet medication which we usually give our patients prior to the procedure. This is the simplest pre-sedation instruction which we give to our patients. Of course, we would always expect our patients to be accompanied by someone. The reason is because they're going to be sleeping. It's always better and always important that somebody is there with them to take care of them when the procedure is over, and so that they can be taken back home. So that's the reason we'll always be some caretaker is there always to accompany the patient to the practice. So these are the pre-surgical or pre-sedation instructions. So once the procedure is over, the commonest question is, I'm 4 hours fasting, I am hungry, and the procedure is for 2 hours, 3 hours. Can I eat something immediately? Should I continue my fasting? No, you need not continue your fasting. In fact, we give something very cold and bland, ice creams, great, immediately after the procedure. So you can actually take something that's cold, bland, immediately after the procedure. One, if there is anything that is done in the mouth, the chillness help to reduce the inflammation, to promote the blood clot and to prevent bleeding. And also, this increases the sugar levels in our body, whatever the food that you're going to take, which is going to give us rapid energy for the sugar that we take, so that we can resume and then become normal as early as possible. Also, some of the post-sedation instructions are, one is, we will the effect of the sedative will continue to be there for a few hours after the procedure. So it's legally not a great idea, it's not allowed, and also it's not a wise idea for you to drive or cook. Anything that's going to require your attention, it's better that we avoid it for 24 hours post the sedation that's been given. Simple, because our reflexes might be little dampened, can be little less, which can cause some errors of judgment when you're driving, when you're cooking. So it's better to avoid those when you're doing that. And also, because of the effect of sedation, there might be a slight giddiness or dizziness. It's called postural hypotension. When you lie down and get up, we might feel little dizzy. This is again because our body takes little time to push the blood that is there in our legs to our head. So this is why we feel lightheaded. So this can also happen immediately after sedation for some time. It's important that you don't jump out of the bed and start walking. If you're going to lie down for sit, stand for a few seconds, compose yourself, and then start walking. Of course, it always makes sense to have somebody assisting you for the initial few hours after the procedure. I think this pretty much sums up all the pre and post sedation instructions. If there are any questions, please do ask us. We'll be happy to answer. This is Dr. Arun from Pearl's Dentistry, running our dental centers in Chennai Raja Annamalai Puram's in the year 2001. Until our next video, bye bye and thank you.
Do you like the video? Press the like button. Do subscribe and click on the bell icon to receive such videos. Thank you.